Good morning, children. Yesterday I have given the notes, the file of lesson number 15. Yes, in that workbook, notebook and textbook. Everything was given. I hope you have completed it. If suppose not, then complete it by today. So, today we are going to start with our new chapter of this month. Yes, that is chapter number 16, A Busy Month. So, all of you, take the textbook in your hand. Page number 120. Okay, don't open right now. Just listen to my words. So let's start with our chapter. Okay, now children, the title of the chapter is A Busy Month. Now, what is meant by busy month? Busy month means that the month in which we are busy. It is called a busy month. For example, let us take your father and mother. Okay, if the father is a shop, he's a shopkeeper, then during the month, during the festival season, he is busy with his work. Yes or no? Is he having any time? No, he doesn't have time. If you will tell also that, Daddy, please let us go here, let us go there. What does he say? Right now I am very busy. After some time we'll go. Does he say like this? That means what? It is a busy month for him. Okay, now for mother also, during the festivals, he had to do a lot of work. He has to prepare different kind of snacks. She has to clean the house. Fine. So there are a lot of things your mother does during the festival season. She has to do a lot of shopping also. So during the festival month, she will also say that she is also busy. So these are month. Fine. Now, but birds are not like us. They doesn't go for shopping. They doesn't own any kind of shop. They doesn't sell the things. So how their life is busy. So in this chapter, we are going to learn about the busy things in which they are involved. Okay, now. Let me give you a quick idea. In this chapter, we are going to see about the different kind of nest different birds make. Now, for example, sparrow, crow, there are variety of birds are there. Yes, all make their own nest, and the nests are also different. Do you get that? The nests are also different. If you compare the sparrow with the crow, if two kind of nests are there, you will find a lot of difference. Fine, so imagine there are variety of birds are there. So, how much variety of nest will be there? Okay. So, we will going to learn. And nest means, you all know, na? Nest means the home which is built by the birds. Then we will talk about their teeth. Then we will talk about their beak. Then we are going to talk about the claws. Okay. These are all the things we are going to learn afterwards. Right now, we will just focus on the kind of, that is nest. So, let us start with our chapter. Let me read. Okay, dear children, it is 3 o'clock in the afternoon. There are no clouds in the sky. The sun is burning hot. Now, here the climate is given. So, 3 o'clock in the afternoon means during the afternoon, the sun is burning. That means there are no clouds. Usually, when there are clouds in the sky, we can't see the sun. It happens during the rainy season. Yes. But if we see the sky, the sun, if we are able to see the sun rays also, we can, if we feel the sunlight, that means there are no clouds in the sky. So it is called clear sky. Okay. The sparrow, dove and sunbirds have started working in pair as they prepare to make their nest. Now this is the best time for the birds to make their own nest. Okay. Not during the rainy season and not during the winters also. They start making their nest during the summers. That is when the sun is burning hot. Okay, now they work in pairs. Now they work in pair means just like R. Can a single individual, a single person can make a house of its own? No, he cannot make. If there is a building work going on, what happens? We can see a lot of workers are there. Yes, suppose if the family is making a kacha house also, one person cannot do the all work. Yes, all the family members we have seen in the previous chapter. How the family members were involved in making a house. Similarly, here also, the birds, they work in pair. Work in pair means they also work in a group. Okay, pair means two birds, three birds, like this they do. Okay, as they prepare to make their nest. Okay, now some of the birds have already made their nest. Okay, some have started, some have already made. So, this kind of work is going on. In some of the nest, the eggs have hatched. Now, there are different scenario given over here. Some birds are busy in making the nest. Some birds have completed the nest. Some birds are there whose nest also completed. Yes, who have given eggs, and the eggs has been hatch also. Hatch means what? When the egg break naturally. Yes, small baby comes out. This is the common thing you also know. Okay, so there are some nests in which small babies are there. There are some nests in which eggs are there. So different scenarios are there on the tree. In some of the nests, the egg have hatched. The parent bird are busy feeding the chicks. Okay, now when the small baby comes out, yes, when the egg hatch, when the egg break, small baby, that is what chicks, they are called chicks or flitling. It is called flitling, okay. Chicks or flitling, yes, both words are there, but chicks is a common word. Small babies are called chicks. Now, when they come out, who takes care of the parent, that is either the mother or either the father? They take care by bringing some insects for them, small insects, by bringing some grains for them to eat, yes. And after some days, when the baby grows enough, okay, what happened? It flews away and find the food on its own. Okay, now, but when it is small like a chick, the parents are busy in feeding. Feeding means like your mother, how she feeds you. She gives you food to eat. Yeah, you eat your food by yourself. No, she gives you. Okay, she feeds you. She prepared the food for you. You are not preparing your own food. She prepares for you. She gives to you, and then you have it. That means your mother is feeding you. So this is the thing. Similarly for the birds also, with different kind of insects and other thing. Okay, now what kind of food the birds are bringing? They are bringing different kind of insects or different kind of grains or some things accordingly. Fine. Now in our courtyard also, there is a baby dove. There is another egg in the nest, but it has not hatched yet. Now in our courtyard means the storyteller who is telling the story over here. He is telling that in our courtyard, in his courtyard. Courtyard means what? If you have an individual house, yes, the place outside it. Have you seen an individual house, a bungalow? Yes, the extra space which is given outside, not inside the house. If you step outside, you will find there is some space given over here. Yes, that is called a courtyard. Fine. So in our courtyard also, there is a baby dove. So the storyteller, whoever is over here, he is telling that there is a dove, baby dove. Now in the picture you can see, we can call it as pigeon. They are telling as dove. Okay. So there is another egg in the nest, but it has not hatched yet. So there is the dove has given a egg. The dove has laid the egg, but it has not hatched right now. After some days, the egg going to hatch on its own. So this is the thing. Next page we will continue it afterwards. Now read the things on your own.